Hi everyone, in this video, we are going to talk about a new way to create dummy variables. If you have a categorical variable with many categories, like 3 categories, 4 categories, it may take you a while to write the if-else function to create the dummy variables that you are using. So we are going to use a new package today. It is called FastDummies. So you want to install that package first, like put the name in the quotation mark and run that line. Once the installation is finished, you can actually run the library function so that you can load that package and start using the functions in the package. So the function we are going to use is called dummy columns. But let us create a data set first. So I'm going to call it data 1, and I'm going to name it as a data frame. My first variable is ID number from 1 to 5, and my second variable is named as season. Of course, I need to have 5 observations for the season. So I'm going to have spring, winter, fall, and summer. So let's make it this way. And maybe we can add another categorical variable just to show you how easy this is using the function. I'm going to name it year. And for the year, I'm going to just use 2021 and 2022. And I'm also creating 5 observed values here, like this. Yeah, so you can run that so that the data 1 is defined, and you can even run data 1 so you can see the whole data set in the console here. So you can see we have ID, season, and year. Season and year are categorical variables. So in order to create dummy variables for season and year, you can actually use dummy columns, and you put the data set name within the parentheses. So if you run that, it will generate a larger data set. You can see we have more columns now. We have season fall, which is the fall dummy variable, indicating 1 if you are observing fall, and indicating 0 if you are observing not fall. We also have spring dummy variable, summer, winter, and we also have year dummy variables because our year is also created as a categorical variable. So you can see year 2021 is a dummy variable, the value 1 indicating it is from 2021. So that's the idea. You can see how quick it is. And you can also rename that data set. Maybe you can add, give it a new name. So this data set will be saved and you can use that data set for further analysis. So you can see this data 1 dummy is defined with 5 observations and 9 variables now. But when you have a dummy variable, you may know, like when you have a categorical variable with 4 categories, A, B, C, D, you don't really need 4 dummy variables because you can define D1 equals 1 if it is A, and D1 equals 0 if it is not A. Same thing, you can define your dummy variable 2 and let it equals 1 if it is B, and let it equals 0 if it is not B. So this is the idea of the dummy variable. You are actually indicating whether it is one certain category or not. So if it is C, and then D3 equals 0 if it is not C. And from this, you can see you don't really need to create 4 dummy variables, because D1 equals 0, indicating it is not A. D2 equals 0, it will not be category B. and D3 equals 0, indicating it is not category C. So that you know when it is D1 equals 0, D2 equals 0, and D3 equals 0, that means it is not category A, not B, not C, and that is indicating category D. So whenever you have 4 categorical variables, you only need 3 dummy variables. If you have 6 categorical variables, then you need 5 dummy variables. So you only need one less in terms of the categories to create the dummy variables. So as we just said, we only need one less dummy variables comparing with the categories there. So which means we don't need 4 dummy variables for season, we don't need 2 dummy variables for year. And we can actually do that by using the dummy columns function, and we also set up remove the first dummy as true. So remove the first dummy as true means the first dummy will be removed so that you are just creating 3 dummy variables for season and 1 dummy variable for year. So let's see that. So you can see here we have spring dummy, summer dummy, and winter dummy, and we only have a year dummy there. And that's the idea of creating the dummy variables so that you can directly use these dummy variables for modeling. I'm going to name that as dummy new so that you can actually directly use this data that is created through this function for modeling.